trustworthiness has to be some kind of average over time. And lo and behold, this is important change because in recommender systems, you have to discount with passage of time, for at least empirically it has been proven that way, because tastes change with time and popularities change. So it's important to take time into account. And you get, you will get the gist of how the algorithm works, and now it's your free game. You can try to incorporate time. Notice here, we simply count the votes. But for example, if 100 people vote for 4, and one person votes for 5, and one person votes for 1, this will get 1, this will get 1. But our intuition is 5 should get more because he's closer to the majority vote. In other words, in original schema, this doesn't involve any distances between options. But you can make it depend on that, and you can make an algorithm maybe that, in fact, it can be used for recommender systems and so forth. Math is relatively simpler. You can ignore the proof of convergence, unless you're a mathematician, and try to tweak it to produce something new. And it would be really nice to exercise your own creativity during this course, in which you use the tools that you are going to learn to do some new stuff for your own interest. Okay, so I'll see you next week.